Hey guys, welcome to TutLinks. In this tutorial, we will deploy a REST API implemented using FastAPI framework to Heroku. So without further ado, let's get started. For the sake of demonstration, I have created a sample demo project and hosted it on GitHub. Now I'll log into my free Heroku account and create a new app. And I'll give the name of the app as fast-api-tutlinks and select the default region and click on create app. Select the deployment method as GitHub. Connect to GitHub if you have not done so and ensure that you are able to see your username and search for the repo name. So here I have selected fast-api. And I'll search for the FastAPI that has the demo. And once I search for it, the results, click on connect. After connecting to the FastAPI demonstration repository that has the FastAPI demo endpoint, choose the branch that you want to deploy. I have default master branch selected and ensure you click on enable automatic deployments. Because whenever you make any changes to this repository, it will automatically be published to this application on Heroku. Once you select the master branch, click on deploy branch. Wait for the build process to gather and install all the required dependencies from the requirements.txt file present in our repository. Once the build succeeds, you will see the message your app was successfully deployed. Click on View button to land on our application. You will notice that there is an application error because we have only installed the dependent packages, but we did not provide the Heroku deployment manager command to run in order for our application to be up and running. Let's do that. So we will come back to Visual Studio Code and add a new file named Procfile. So this profile will be used by the Heroku in order for it to run any application after the installation of dependencies. So in this, type in the command web colon gunicorn space hyphen w, the number of worker processes space 4, because I want this application to run on 4 worker processes. And hyphen k space the worker class, which is ubicon.workers.ubiconworker, and the name of the application where our app is initialized, which is main.py. So just give it main, and the variable name where our fast API is initialized, which is app. As we are telling the Heroku deployment process to run our API based on gunicorn, we also have to install that dependency. Type the command pip install gunicorn and wait for the process to install. Once the gunicorn module is installed, add it to the requirements.txt file by typing the command pip space free space greater than space requirements.txt, and we will see that the gunicorn has been added to the requirements.txt. With this approach, we will ensure the proper version of gunicorn is added to our requirements.txt so that this version of gunicorn is compatible with other dependent modules of this repository. Now, if you run the same command given in the proc file on a Windows PC, you will end up with an error with module not found fnctl. So in order for this application to run, all you have to do is type in ubicon space main colon app and then hyphen hyphen reload, and you'll see the app running on port 8000 on localhost. So let me stop that and commit this change and push to master branch by typing git space add dot and commit this change with the message added GUnicorn and Procfile for Heroku and hit enter. And finally push the changes so that they reflect on GitHub. Alright, we see the Procfile got updated here. And based on our deployment configuration, Heroku automatically deployed our latest changes to the application. Now let's refresh our app to see the latest changes. The beauty of this FastAPI framework is it automatically generates the swagger for its all endpoints. So for that you can see /docs. Here you can see our default get endpoint. We can try it out as well here by just clicking on execute. We'll see the response with status 200 code and the response body. Now let's invoke this API call in Postman and send a request. You'll see the body with a message hello.tutlinks.com. Congratulations! Now you are able to successfully deploy a REST API implemented using FastAPI framework to Heroku. The full source code for this project is mentioned in the description of this video. If you found this video useful, please give it a like. And please do subscribe to our channel and enjoy your day. Thank you.